Good morning, YouTube world. It's your girl, Kimberly, out in the garden this morning. Today, we are talking yellow crookneck squash. A very, very beautiful squash, and it tastes very, very good. I'm usually in my garden pretty early in the morning because I'm always checking on my squash. I don't really have that many bees that frequent my garden, so I always have to make sure that my squash are being properly pollinated. And by doing that, I physically come out here and pollinate the squash myself, because again, I don't have a lot of bees that come in the garden, so I want to make sure that I'm going to have a nice harvest this season. As you know, you've seen my other videos, but if not, the male stem or flower of the squash plant is just a straight stem with a beautiful yellow flower. See, there's the yellow flower there. And here's a straight stem for the male flower right here. Very beautiful. I've personally eaten the flower, and it is really, really, really good. I love it. I pick it, I wash it, I eat it, and it tastes really good directly from the squash plant. And as you can see under there, there's a grown squash. And this is a smaller version of the female squash. And this is how a female squash looks. It normally has a smaller bulb. This one is a little bit more developed, but it normally has this small bulb like right below the flower. And that's how you can tell the difference between a male flower and a female. Again, the female grows the fruit and usually has a small bulb at the bottom. Okay, this one is a little bit more developed. And the male flower of the summer squash, yellow squash, usually just has a straight stem, which is this one, with all the pollen in the inside, as you can see, with the little ant crawling around in there. But again, this morning I was like, you know what, let me go out here and check to see if any of my squash are ready to be harvested, because I have a nice amount of squash in my garden. And as you can see, there's some over there. So I want you guys to kind of do this with me. I planted my squash like on April 23rd. So normally it's like 50 to 55 days and the squash is ready to be harvested. But I also go by the touch and the size of the squash when I decide it's also ready. The standard is when you can pierce it with your fingernail, that's a really, really good sign that it's mature enough yet still tender enough for you to pick. Also, when it's about 4 to 7 inches long, it's time to harvest. So we're gonna take my ruler and we're gonna see if this squash here, sorry, is ready to harvest. All right, let's see. This one is close to 4. Let me give that one a little bit longer. This one I can kind of look at and tell it's a little shorter, so it's not ready. Sorry, you guys. Got the leaves all in the way there. This one is close to more so 3, so that one's not ready. You can almost get a look of them when you get comfortable with your squash. You can kind of look at it and go, that's about 3 inches long. That's about 4. But I'm doing this for most people because sometimes it is hard to just look at it and tell if it's ready or not. Now look at this cutie. This one is a little fatty. Aw, it's so cute. So let's put the little tape measure here. And excuse me, guys, if you're like, what is he doing with this video? I know it's kind of shaky. But let's see. This one is about 4 inches. So we'll go ahead and harvest this one. The way I harvest my squash is very, very carefully. I don't want to damage the main stem of my plant. So I'm gonna make sure I cut the part that's attached to the actual squash. Some people use knives. You have to use what you're comfortable with. I personally don't mind using scissors at all. So I'm gonna lift my plant up some, open this so you guys can see it, and I'm just gonna cut the actual stem where the squash is. See how simple? And look at this. There's my first harvested squash for this season. Oh, it's pretty. Look at that. It's a good looking squash. And let's do the fingernail test. Look at that. That's how you know it's tender. See those marks right there? Really easy to penetrate with a fingernail. Not hard at all. If you also notice something I've done differently with my garden, I've kind of attached strings to the squash because they grow really, really wide and they spread out very much so. I thought I would attach strings to it and kind of anchor it up here. That way, when it starts to grow, I'm not worried about them really laying on the ground as much. And I can kind of control them from basically blocking out the sun for the smaller squash. Because see this one right here? This is a much smaller plant. And it wasn't getting as much sun because this big one was blocking the sun out. So I had to string it up some so that I give the smaller squash plant some space to grow. This one has flowers on it, so I know it's getting some type of sun. And look, you guys get to see that. Did you see that? That was a little bee. So, again, that's how you can tell when your squash is ready to harvest, when it's about 4 to 7 inches long, and you can pierce it with your fingernail. All right, you guys, so I'm going to do a little bit more harvesting, or attempt to. And then I'm going to enjoy my squash later on this evening. Happy gardening. Love you guys. And if I pick any more squash, I'll make sure I show you on the video. What's going on, you guys? Guess what? Look what I was able to harvest out of my garden this morning. Look at the beautiful yellow summer squash. These are all about 4 inches long and they look amazing. Look at that. I don't know if you guys can see. One of the indications that squash is also ready is when they're roughly four to seven inches long, but also when they have this beautiful gloss on them. See that gloss? That's also a sign that they're ready to be harvested. And as I showed you a few seconds ago in the video, when you can actually put your fingernail through the squash, it's a slight pierce, like you see that little end, that's from my fingernail. And no pressure whatsoever. It was really easy to do that. But this is what my harvest is this morning. And I am very proud. A proud mother of my first harvest, squash harvest of the season. And even though this is what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 squash here, I still have some that I've left on there on the other plants because they're just not big enough. I have some over there. I don't know if you guys can see them, but there's yellow flowers and there's some squash over in that section there. So those were not ready, so I did not pick those. But for a first time harvest for this